Hi everybody, it's Sam here. Thank you for watching today. So this is the last project for my Valentine series 2022. Thoroughly enjoyed making the projects and I hope you've enjoyed them too. If you are new to the channel and you haven't seen what I make or any of my past Valentine's series, then I will share the playlist up here. I think there's 4 or 5 years worth of projects, so there's a lot there and lots of inspiration, so check it out. But for today and for the final project, I'm going to show you how I've made this very cute little cracker wrap. So there's 4 1x1 inch crackers holding a pack of Rolos. So Rolos are just that cute chocolate that you eat for yourself and then everyone says, do you love me enough to give me your last Rolo, because they're so good no one ever wants to share them. So there is a pack of Rolos in each of these, so you could just make the crackers on their own. They're nice little table favors. But then I had the idea to make it look like your blanket, your picnic blanket. I've got one of these picnic blankets and then this wrap piece that goes over with a handle like this. And you have the blanket kind of sticking out either end. And I thought it would be nice for these crackers because you've got all this ribbon. And I've got quite a few crackers on my channel now, so I'll share the playlist for those, because you might want to do some of the other sizes or styles of cracker and wrap it like this. Very easy to do, doesn't take no time at all. And it's just a really fun way to just gift some little chocolates. Very inexpensive, but really, really cute. So let's get into the tutorial and I'll show you how I made it. So this is the paper pad I've used. It's called Lipstick Basics. I think I got this one at the beginning, round about the beginning of last year. It's a really nice one. I've used quite a lot from this. And I just pulled out the love and the cherries with the white background. You've got the cherries with the black background as well. So those are the two that I've used. That was from the range. So depending on how many crackers you want, because I'm doing this as like that stack, so I've got 4 of them together. So you'll want 4 pieces of 4.5 by 8.5. And then along the 4.5 side, you're going to score at 1 inch, 2 inch, 3 and then 4. And then along the longer side, you're going to score at 1, 1.5 and 2. You could then just flip and score the same at that end, or you can just carry on along and then score at 6.5, 7 and 7.5. Okay, so just repeat that on however many you're doing. Then you want to fold and burnish all of your score lines. Okay, so what I'm going to do is use this side because you can actually see the score lines much better. So you should have 3 score lines at each end and then 1 inch section as well. What you want to do is where you've got the 3 together is fold it in half, so you've got 1 score line on one side and you can see I've got a score line on the other. I'm going to keep it this way up because it's easier for you to see what I'm doing. Where you've got the square, you want to remove that completely, so I'm just going to cut that out like so. All of this now here, we want to cut little crocodile teeth. So if you've ever made any of my crackers, as I've mentioned at the beginning, I think the playlist's already been shared. If not, check the playlist out. But it's how you make any cracker. If you want it to pull, then you would just do this. So you can see I'm just putting these little crocodile teeth, and then when I get to the fold, cut straight up there and kind of just join it like so. Okay, it doesn't have to be exact, just the thinner you do these, the better the pull. And also just a neater finish you'll get. I mean, to be honest, we probably could just do, let me just try it, just to give you, in fact, I'll do it on the other end. So we'll just do this one like this. Okay, so now when you open it up, I turn it that way, you can see you got all those teeth. So having them really weak here means that you can pull it apart. But I just want to try something because I've not done it on the other. So again, at the other end, you're folding it in half. So you've got a score line on one side, score line on the other. Now that square will be in the bottom right-hand corner. So just remove that. And then you could now possibly, let's just see, cut an angle or, you know, a wedge off of there. And then cut a triangle over the score line either side. Like so. And then again, now thinking about it, you're going to have to cut this in so you have a half inch in the middle section. I'll explain that in a second. So we've got that there. So right now, if I left it like that, you wouldn't be able to close this tight and the gift inside might fall out. If you wanted to keep it completely secure, you want there to be a half inch piece here. So you'd have to come over more with your cuts, something like that. Okay, again, you can eyeball all this. You don't need to be getting your rulers out or anything. And if some are bigger than others, it doesn't matter because it all gets hidden with the ribbon. But you could, because we're not going to be pulling these, do it that way. And doing one like this and the other like that isn't going to affect the way this all comes together. So it's up to you. I mean, obviously that way is quicker. Just bring it around like this and you can check, because these are all the tabs. But you want that to, when you wrap your ribbon, you want it to come together. I mean, there's a tiny gap. You're always going to get a little hole. Whereas on this one here, when you squeeze all that together, it's much, much tighter. Okay, so have a play around, see what, you know, gifts you're putting in there. It's entirely up to you. So now I also like to just tidy off the edges here. So all of these pieces now are your tab for us to attach it together. Like so. So if I open it that way, you can really see the shape. Okay, so it's up to you which way you have it in terms of the cuts. So now I'm going to grab my quick grab glue, and you want to add your glue all along these tab pieces. So the small ones as well, and then fold it over and then fold that one over. Make sure it all folds down flat. These are great for making now as well, so you might want to make a few. Just keep them flat and just pop your gift in and then the ribbon when you need them. And then I like to fold it off to the other side, and then you can just burnish it like so. Okay, so you'll see both go in. Actually, that one doesn't go in, so you get a different look. So once the ribbon's tied around it, they're still going to look the same, but you can't push that one in. See that one, I can really squeeze down. So if it was really tight with the ribbon, it would be like that, or you can have that effect. But once the ribbon's on, you don't really see any of that detail anyway. So I've got my ribbon here. It all depends on how big you want your bow. I'm going to secure one end and then pop the Rolos in. I've got a very long piece of ribbon here, but I don't want to waste it. Okay, and then I'm going to pop my Rolos in that end and then just seal this one off. Keep the bow on the top. Okay, and then I've got my little topper here. So these are these little tile, alphabet tiles, and these are all from Simply Creative. You get a black and white pack, but I've split mine because I like to just keep them, you know, separate in my little drawers here. So you've got your black and white, you've then got your multicoloured, and these are larger. These are your mini, and then these are mini in the gold and holographic. I think the silver as well. I might have silver somewhere, but there's loads. They're only about £1, maybe £1.99 a pack. Really handy if you don't want to get your stamps out and things like that. So I've used the white here, and I've got my other ones all ready. So I've got Cuddle, Be Mine, Kisses and Love You. So I've just stuck them onto some mirrored card and done some little flag tail detail at the end. And then did I put foam? Yes, I did. So I'll just add some foam pads there and just stick that on the top, and then we can make the wrap. Okay, so just playing around with this piece of card here. So this is 12 by 4.5, but it doesn't need to be 12. I think 11 and 3/4 will be fine. Yeah, 4.5. So you just want to pop them together. So I've got two facing one way, two facing the other. 4.5 is the width of this here, and I want my join to be on the bottom. Once I seal this, I won't be able to take it. You know, the next person that will undo it will be the person I'm giving it to. So you just want to tightly wrap it kind of just get it in place. Use the corners there to kind of put a bit of a score line, or a fold, should I say. So yeah, you definitely don't need it as long as that. I'm just going to put a bit of a mark there. I can tell you how long this is. So I'd say do 10, then you know you've definitely got enough. So I'm going to run some double-sided tape along the bottom there, so I know that's the bottom. So this is my top piece. So this is where I want to add my handle and any decoration. So I'm wondering whether to stamp some hearts all over it. Well, that might look a bit busy. I'm wondering whether to just do a bit of a hanging charm and have a red handle on it. I might just stamp directly on here, actually, within this section here. You can see where I've got my four folds there. I think I'm going to stamp a Valentine sentiment there, and then that's where the handles are going to be attached. So I've just stamped forever and always, and then where I've got my folds, I'm just going to line it up with a score line, with a track, sorry, and just so I can see where it is. And it'll just give it a bit of a neater finish. Okay, so that's how the wrap will look. I'm going to do my handle. In fact, I'll leave the scoreboard out. So you might want yours longer, but I'm going to do 6 by 3/4, and then I'm going to score 3/4 at each end. Okay, and then in between those score lines, I'm just going to put a curve in the cardstock there. So I've got my handle, and then just fold out the sides like so. And that's going to go on the top there. And just add your glue and pop that one up there. And then just stick this one. Mine ends up being about 5/8 in from the side. I thought it'd be nice to add some faux hardware. So I've got these brads, which are all different, you know, designs on the end. So we've got hearts here. I think they're going to look perfect just in here. And I think these were from... In fact, these are from a charity shop. My mum found a box full of tons and we halved it, I remember now. So apologies, I can't find where they're from, but I'm sure I'll have a little look on Amazon and see. But you can see you get all different designs. There's red hearts there as well. There's flowers, stars, all different colours. And, you know, they're great for finishing off your projects. So yeah, I will see if I can find. I'm sure they'll be on Amazon or eBay. So I ended up using some hot glue and attached them because they actually were, the hole was bigger, but the kind of split pin on the back of it is right at the top. So they were coming further down. Anyway, I just stuck them with some hot glue. I cut the metal ends off. So now I'm just going to have one of each design. So I've got the love and the cherries, and then I'll have that one and that one on the bottom. Yeah, so they're all odd. And just pop it under the ribbon. Like I said, once it's in, that's it then. So I'm going to secure this with some glue. I want it nice and tight, just like your picnic blanket, and it's wrapped right up. Oh, it looks so cute. Just want to make sure I get all that ribbon out, because that's what I think gives it its cuteness. So I'm going to use the Collall glue here, so it will just really strengthen the bottom. So a little bit fiddly getting it all in, but once it's there, just hold that, like I said, as tight as you can get it, and that will just give it that nice cute look. Okay, there you have it, my little cracker wrap. I'm not going to decorate it anymore because there's so much with the ribbons on the side there. I don't think it needs anything else. That's just going to sit in the hamper like so. I think it's adorable. So I hope you've enjoyed this year's Valentine's series. Like I said, anybody new to the channel, check out the playlist that I would have shared and look at the past years as well, because this is the fourth or fifth year now of Valentine's projects. So there's a lot on there and hopefully gives you lots of inspiration. But for today, I'm very pleased with my little, very cute cracker wrap. And I can't wait now to finish my hampers and get them delivered. As always, thank you for watching and I'll be back again very soon. Bye.